Hello, everyone, and welcome to New Tech Tuesday Tutorials. I am your host, Richard Evans. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Continuing with the 3Play 3P2 system, I'd like to show you how to play back your clips with speed control. So instant replay isn't just about, you know, replaying clips from the past, but it's about replaying those clips with some dynamic speed controls for highlight reels or even official review, making the 3Play not just part of playback, but an important part of the game itself. All right, enough talking. Let me show you how it's done, son. All right, here we are in the 3Play 3P2 interface. I have my control panel also hooked up and ready to go. And I'm not going to do any capturing of this game today. I'm just going to be playing back different clips with speed controls. So I'm going to primarily be taking a look at the T-bar here in the left, but then also a little bit of the jog wheel over here in the middle. All right, now this, all of the methods that I'm going to show you here will work for both the clip list and the playlist, so keep that in mind whenever you're going forward. All right, and also just to take a look at the interface here, I wanted to just give you a quick little rundown. So we have my A output over here, and underneath I have this blue bar here letting me know that I'm actually playing back a clip. And then you'll also notice whenever I hit play that there will be a light blue bar that will go across here, kind of like a timeline to show you where you are in that clip. Also, you can see how much time you have left, duration of it, etc. But then also here at the bottom right of that, you'll see it currently says 0%. That's going to correspond to the different speed controls that we add to it. All right, so let me just go ahead and play this clip without any speed control first. I'll hit play, and then you'll see that it says 100% in the bottom right. All right, passes it off, and dunk, nice. All right, so let's go ahead and reset that clip, and let me show you the first method on using the T-bar. So on the T-bar, you can use this as kind of like a gas pedal in the current mode that it's in. All right, in the current mode that it's in, this light here is dark. This is just going to be the gas pedal side of things. So think about it as having your speed at the top is 100%, and then your speed at the bottom is 0%. Okay, so let's go ahead and play that clip back. So right now it'll be at 100% when I hit play here. But now if I start to bring this back, you'll notice that it will start to slow down. All right, I can bring it all the way to zero, bring it to a complete stop. And then I can ramp it forward, accelerate, and dunk. Nice. Just like that. All right, so that was pretty easy. 0% at the bottom, 100% at the top. Very cool. All right, now there is another way to use the T-bar. And this method, you would click on this button here, the plus minus. And what that will allow you to do is now your zero percent is going to be right here smack dab in the middle, and at the very top is going to be 200% forward, and then at the bottom is 200% backwards. So you can go backwards and forward in time doing it this way. All right, so it's kind of up to you and how you want to do it. So let's go ahead and try that out. Let's hit play here, and right now it's at 100%. I need to get back to right around here, and then I can bring it down, bring it up 200%, or I can even bring it backwards. All right, so the controls won't even really do anything until you cross the mark that you are supposed that it's starting to play out as. All right, so for example, right now it's kind of at zero. If I hit play here, it will be at 100%, which nothing will happen until I get to 100%, and then I can start to move it backward and forward and all the way backwards in time. All right, so keep that in mind as well whenever you are doing these. So the T-bar does have a little bit of I don't want to say complexity, but a different way of doing this in the 200% method. All right. Now, the next way I want to show you how to do some speed control on your 3Play is to use the jog wheel here. All right. Now, what this will allow us to do, the only thing when you do this, though, is it will stop your playback. So if I hit play here and then I use my jog wheel, well, now it just stopped, went to 0%. But this will allow you to go through frame by frame, and you can literally do this by hand, go up and back. This is really good for like instant replays on, you know, like just trying to see if something's going out of bounds, so you can stop it, give this to the referees, etc., so they can see exactly what's going on here. All right, so you can literally just bring this backward and forward, but when you do that, it will stop the playback, and as you notice here, that percent sign is at zero, because I'm not really playing it back. I'm just going frame by frame manually like this. Okay, sorry. Okay, so that is the three different ways that you can use the control panel to change the playback speed of your different clips. Again, this can also be used in your playlist mode. So if you're playing your clips back in your playlist, you can still use these same methods speed control on both of those. And as usual, there's no wrong or right way to do this. It's just kind of up to you what you prefer. Dive in and have some fun. A lot of really cool and fun things that you can do with 3P2 and speed controls. Now, if you like this video, don't forget to subscribe to the New Tech YouTube channel at youtube.com/newtechinc. Give us a like, a comment, whatever. We'd love to hear from you. And if you're posting your work on social media, we love to see that too. So tag us using the hashtags NewTech, TriCaster, or 3Play. And if you're looking for more information about NewTech products and services, contact your local reseller or visit our website, newtech.com. And you can even sign up for a free NewTech product demonstration by going to newtech.com/demo. And if you're looking for professional training on NewTech products and services, check out NewTech University by visiting newtech.com/newtech-u. Thank you all so much for watching. I'll see you again soon for another episode of NewTech Tuesday Tutorials.